For example, during both fighting and playing, dogs jump on one another and sometimes try to pin or force the other into a down position, like Lola. Dogs bite, they chase, they snarl and show their teeth and they woke.
Taking a video of this.
These similarities
really good.
Are why we sometimes refer to rough and tumble play between dogs as play fighting. Even though on first take, play fighting and real fighting may look similar, there are some key differences between the two. For example, during play, dogs often engage in self-handicapping behaviour that occurs when one player voluntarily puts herself in a vulnerable or disadvantaged position in order to give her partner a competitive advantage.
Wow, this video is pretty good. Shorts to Katie. Dogs fighting. It's not finished yet.
One example of a self-handicap behaviour that dogs use during play is a voluntary down where one player falls to the ground without assistance from her partner.
Ah, so it's like when she keeps falling down.
And may flip over on her back and expose her belly. This type of behaviour would never occur during a real fight.
Yeah, but she keeps doing this.
Yeah, she goes on her belly.
She
lots.
Goes on her belly, yeah.
Dogs also use play signals during play. One of the more commonly seen signals is the play bow go. Dog doing a bow will face her partner and crouch down with her forelimbs nearly touching the ground.
Lola does that too.
Yeah, she does it too.
So they are playing.
At the same time, the hind end is high in the air and the tail is often wagging. Is her tail wagging?
Probably. You can watch the video later. I can't watch, I can't concentrate. They're pretty much playing, like, it's guaranteed.
In our research on dog play, we found that play bows and voluntary downs tend to occur in conjunction with one another, and that they may work together to help keep fun, play fun, and encourage the participants